Lots of people put relationship issues at the top of their New Year's resolution list. And for many years, radio listeners have been looking for help with their marriages or their significant relationships. And they've turned to Dr. Laura Schlessinger for advice. Her new book is called The Proper Care and Feeding of Marriage. Isn't that a great title? And it's full of tips for couples trying to build a better marriage. Dr. Laura, good morning.
Good morning. I only wish people were putting their marriages top on their resolution list.
But
probably
they're not, maybe.
Their fat tummies or...
Well, there's a lot of people put themselves, and it's all about them, at the top of their New Year's resolution list.
That's the number one reason marriages are in trouble.
Really?
Yeah, well, you wake up in the morning and turn over and look at him or her, and the first thing you think of is, oh, they didn't do this or they didn't do that, or I'm irritated, oh, look, I have the gray hair. Instead of, how today can I make his or her life worth living? What can I do to make them want to be alive and want to be with me? That should be the first thought in the morning when you roll over and see your beloved.
People must not be doing this, because when you look at this new survey that came out, AOL and Women's Day surveyed 3,000 married women. The numbers were astounding. This came out the other day. More than half of the women said they weren't sure they would marry their husband again, and a third said they would definitely not pick the same spouse. Did that surprise you?
No. The book I wrote before this was The Proper Care and Feeding of Husbands. And I want to tell you that from the time I've spent on the air talking to women who crumb about their husbands, how many of the one question they didn't ask these women, would you want to come home to you?
Oh, right.
I think the vast majority of these unhappy women are bad wives.
Why is that?
Why are they bad wives, or why do I think so?
why are they bad wives? I mean, three-fourths of them admit to keeping secrets from their husbands.
Yeah, well, you know,
is that okay?
If they're spending secrets like what? That I'm hungering for the guy next door? I mean, what kind of secrets are we keeping from the person who's supposed to be our most intimate, our best friend, and the one we can really trust with our souls? What are you keeping secrets from them for?
What about the 75% of women who said they fantasize about another man?
Well, you know, Burt Lancaster, when he was 30, comes into my mind now and then.
So is that okay, or is that detrimental?
If he's planted in my brain 24 hours a day, that's detrimental, because I've asked a lot of men, okay, you see the cute honey at work, and, you don't know any of the other stuff. She's just looking cute and adorable and wonderful, and she's sweet, and she has makeup on, and her hair is done, and you're thinking of your wife, and you're going, aye. But my question to you is, how much time do you spend thinking about how your wife touches your face and looks dreamily into you and says, I love you and I really appreciate that you worked so hard today so I can take care of the kids. I mean, how much time do you spend thinking about what you give your wife? Do you turn your wife into a honey? One of the things that's in this book is both male and female looking at the husband and wife. How do you help make her feel like more of a woman? Who thinks about that?
What is it that women want from their husbands?
Well, when I did this research, I thought I was going to find the metrosexual stupidity and that I was going to have to really rail against it. It's not what I found. Feminism, PC stuff, the stuff in the media notwithstanding, women want a strong man they can count on who'll protect them, provide for them, and lift them off their feet and carry them up a flight of stairs into the bedroom. Gone with the Wind, isn't that the best scene? Do you know, can you think of one woman who wouldn't want that trip?
And what do men want from their wives?
They enjoy our softness and our sweetness and how we take the rough edges off life and their own masculinity. They look forward to us taking a house and making it feel like a home. All the soft, gentle things. And, you know, we don't have to give up being smart or competent at things to be a sweet woman to our men.
You say it's pretty simple. You say to reflect on the touching and the spectacular moments. What you're really talking about is sort of changing our mindset towards marriage.
Well, I think, I know as a talk show host and as a shrink, this is probably going to sound, sacrilegious. But I think there's way too much communication with words.
What do you mean by that?
One man, well...
Because we always hear that we're supposed to communicate.
It's wrong. I'm upset that you had more words yesterday on the show than I did. Now, let's negotiate how we're going to do it. That doesn't bring us warm together.
Right.
So when men call and say, their wives are this and they're not feeling attached to them, I go, okay. When you go home, just walk behind her and do this. Just touch her neck, touch her shoulder, touch her arm. Say, your hair looks nice. Just small, insignificant things.
So it doesn't have to be this all the time. Right?
No.
Because people say they fight about petty things and they go back and forth.
Too much time talking. And my section when I talk about communication, the first thing I say is shut up.
Mm-hmm. I like that. Edit yourself.
Yes.
You also say to think about how to provoke good moments.
Yeah.
How do you create
provoke
that?
Good? Well, just like what I was saying. Mm-hmm. Or getting into bed with your dearly beloved and saying, would you like your hands rubbed?
Nice.
Or saying, you know what? I noticed today that there were flowers on the table. With all that you had to do today, honey, it's so nice that you stopped to put flowers on the table because I came home and it just relaxed me. You create these moments by pointing out and looking for these small things instead of...
It's just as easy to go that way
as to nitpick about the small things.
It's just as easy to be nice
about the good things. Yeah. It's actually harder because we're more set to be irritated.
Right. Dr. Laura, we could talk all day. And maybe you'll just have to come back.
But instead, we'll just hold hands.
There you go. Because we don't want to over-talk.
Yes.
Right? You can read an excerpt from The Proper Care and Feeding of Marriage on our website at cbsnews.com.